What was the most exotic Chilean food you had?
Seaweed.
What was one of the most crazy or dangerous experiences you had in Chile?
I fell through a roof.
What was one of the most spiritual experiences you had on your mission?
Well, there's one time I remember, this is about 20 months into my mission. And I've been working really closely with the sister missionaries in my district. They had 5 people that were all about to get baptized, and we're just trying to make sure all of them got what they needed to be able to feel ready. And there was one man who just wasn't sure what he wanted to do. And so I went to the first baptism to support the first one that got baptized, and this man was there. And for a long time in my mission, I'd just been praying to just be able to be an instrument in the Lord's hands, because it's He who is able to carry out the work, and we're just there to help. And so I've been thinking about that a lot, and I just started talking with him after the baptismal service, and I told him about my conversion experience, how I was born in the church, I started reading my scriptures when I was in seminary, I prayed, I learned, I grew, I was baptized when I was 8, and how every bit of my journey has just been step by step, like everyone else's is. I told him how I got callings, I went through the temple, and how I was then on a mission. And I just told him that I know it's true. I couldn't say when I knew it, but the knowledge came in that process. And he just looked at me and looked at me and looked at me and didn't say anything. And then just gave me a hug and said, thank you. And we went back to our area because we had some lessons to teach. But the sisters called me, it wasn't an hour later, and said, we had our lesson with Luis. And he just said, I'm going to get baptized next Saturday. And we couldn't even believe it. But when I heard that, I found somewhere to kneel and just thank God for being an instrument in His hands and for Him letting me touch the life of somebody else. So I think that was probably one of the most spiritual experiences in my mission.
Any funny language mistakes that you made or any other missionaries made?
I'll do one I did that's a little bit more appropriate. When I was teaching about Joseph Smith, once I got the word century and blind man mixed up. They're pretty similar in Spanish, siglo y ciego. And so I was talking and teaching, and I noticed that they were looking at me weird. So I said what I was saying again. They looked at me weird again. And then I thought, what am I saying? And I was saying, Joseph Smith was a boy born in the early 19th blind man. What?
What was one of the greatest life lessons you learned on your mission?
Oh, I think one of the most important lessons I learned is that which you persist in doing gets easier. Not because it's the nature of the thing has changed, but because our capacity to do has increased.
What was one of the best skills or abilities you developed as a missionary?
I think the thing I'm most grateful for is just not quitting. No matter what you're facing, trust in Christ, know that it's part of His plan, and not give up.
Most extreme weather?
Rain.
Awesome. What was one of the hardest things that you experienced on your mission?
I think one of the things a lot of missionaries have a hard time with, and that I certainly did, is knowing how to measure success. It's hard sometimes when you aren't baptizing to know why and to accept that that might happen sometimes. And for me, the hardest times in my mission were the times when I was working the hardest I possibly could. I was working the smartest I possibly could. I was trying to follow the Spirit and live in unity with my companion as best I could. And the results were just not what I wanted. But now, a year later from those times, I can look back and just be so grateful for them and know that they do work out and that people do get baptized and the kingdom of God is built.
What's the best piece of advice you could give to a missionary just heading out to the field?
I think the best advice I could ever give a pre-missionary is don't let your mission be the first time you share the gospel. That is a habit that we need to have our whole lives. And if you start it before, you'll be infinitely ahead and infinitely blessed in your mission.
And finally, what is best advice you could give to a returned missionary just getting home from their mission?
One thing my branch president told me when I was in the MTC, he said, those who understand temple covenants realize that their mission doesn't start when they're set apart. It starts when we receive the temple endowment. And it doesn't end ever. And I think I know that's very true. That the mission doesn't end when we come home, when we go back to college or school or family. It's just the next transfer. And you keep working just as hard. And you keep seeing just as many miracles.